middle of the Ionian Sea, not far from the West Greek mainland, lies an island with a long tradition. The island of Corfu has long been known as an excellent resort base. The beautiful beaches and the blue sea bewitch the Austrian Empress Elizabeth and many English lords. The island has white sandy beaches, but also high steep rocks, olive woods, slender cypresses, vineyards and cornfields. It is more lushly vegetated than other parts of Greece, and it is surely one of the most interesting and most varied of all Greek destinations. The capital of the island is the small port of Corfu, or Kekira as the Greeks themselves call it. Here in the port you can watch local fishermen at work mending their nets and boats, observe ferries landing from the mainland, or admire yachts from all over the world. The town of Corfu is one of the few towns in the Mediterranean in which the majority of the houses still emanate from the past centuries. The narrow streets, small squares and churches have a very special atmosphere. The well-preserved old town and countless staircases might resemble Italy, but the people themselves are definitely Greeks. Corfu is the northernmost Ionian island. The old centre of the town radiates noble peace. At Easter, the town is full of religious chants and believers move from church to church to celebrate the salvation. 98% of all Greeks are Greek Orthodox. It is called Orthodox because it claims to have been the only Christian church faithful to the faith of the apostles, martyrs, and church fathers. But the noisy procession after the Easter prayer is for the eyes and ears rather unorthodox. We can only speculate if they play the Radetzky March in commemoration of the Empress Elizabeth or the Emperor Wilhelm II, who fell in love with this island the same as today's visitors do. Everything in Greece passes slowly and calmly. People meet in cafes, chat and argue and sip typical Greek coffee. The nicest cafes on the island are on the central square, the Esplanada. Under the arcades there are countless cafes with enough visitors from early morning to late evening. Old and young people meet here, as well as tourists and locals having breakfast, drinking frappes or simply enjoying calm days on Corfu. The square is a reminder of the French and later British protectorate. You can still see their traces here. On nice Sundays, people still play the British national sport cricket on the large lawn on the square. It's an unusual picture, but still, this varied mixture of culture and lifestyle is interesting. The well-preserved fortress above the town of Corfu faced, not always successfully, toward intruders and conquerors. The flag of the winners often changed every year. Today there is an excellent view of the town from the castle and there is a good cafe in the castle restaurant. The Austrian Empress Elizabeth had a castle built on Corfu at the end of the 19th century. On her many travels, she fell in love with the island decades earlier. castle modelled on Pompeian architecture. She could escape the more and more unbearable life of the Viennese court, and she could occupy herself with Greek antiquity and mythology. Favourite hero was Achilles, and she had several statues made of him. I like him because he embodies the Greek soul and beauty of the country and the people, she said. He was strong, willful, and he despised all kings and traditions. The unhappy empress explained her affection. Kilometers to the south of Corfu, near the village of Kanoni, there are two small islands. The nearest one, Antilipsi, with the Vlacherna Monastery, is connected to the mainland by a bridge. Behind it there is Ponte Conisi, the island of mice, overgrown with cypresses, with a chapel from the 16th century. The island of mice became world famous thanks to the painting by Birkeland. Due to its landscape, it is definitely worth it to cross over there by boat. To best get to know the whole island, the best way is to make a journey of exploration by car. On picturesque coast roads always in sight of the sea, the eastern coast passes by. Everywhere there are beautiful bays with gorgeous ports and small beaches which invite you to stop and bathe. These small bays give the island a special charm. There are beautifully coloured fishermen's boats, and it is possible to rent one of them and set out on an explorational trip. Travel on the coastal road to the northwest, you go around endless olive woods to one of the most beautiful and mysterious of Corfu's coasts, to the Canal d'Amour, the Channel of Love. Women who swim here and think about a certain man will marry him soon. But the channels are attractive even for those who aren't in love and don't have any intentions of getting married soon. Small beaches and bays bitten out by the sea into the yellow and white sandstone cliffs guarantee awesome swimming conditions.